Hey, Google, stop the music. What's going on, fight fans around the world? Welcome back. We have a fight card this weekend. Rafael Dos Anjos takes on Kevin Lee in the Blue Cross Arena, Rochester, New York. 13 MMA bouts enclosed in an octagon. UFC on ESPN plus number 10, Dos Anjos versus Lee. And in this video, we're going to take a look at the main event, and we're going to do a prediction that starts with some questions based on these two guys. Now, we have Rafael Dos Anjos, who after starting his career pretty strongly at the welterweight division. Let's go from the start. He went on a three-fight winning streak to get the title shot against Anthony Pettis, where he won the UFC world title, defended it once against Donald Cerrone, lost it to Eddie Alvarez, then lost again to Tony Ferguson, and then he makes his move to his current weight division, welterweight. Kevin Lee, on the other hand, went on a five-fight winning streak. Five-fight winning streak. RDA went on a five-fight winning streak as well. Lost to Tony Ferguson in an interim title fight. He was submitted in round number three in a fight that he was winning majority of it. He got top position on Tony Ferguson a lot of the time, but he got triangle choked in the third round, an upsetting defeat. I wouldn't say it's an upset defeat. Everybody pretty much had Ferguson in that fight. Then he went on to go on this little spree of, I'm going to take on the people Khabib already beat, and I'm going to beat him worse. And that started with Edson Barboza on UFC Fight Night 128. Kevin Lee was able to stop Barboza at 2 minutes and 18 seconds in round number 5 due to a doctor stoppage. The doctor stopped it. There was a huge cut above Edson Barboza's eye, and they had to call the fight off. And he started off well in his chase of Khabib, but then he went up against Ally Aquina in a rematch. This Kevin Lee in the rematch was way more favored. He was a favorite in this fight. He was on that huge winning streak. He just came off a loss to Tony Ferguson, but he came off a loss in an interim title fight, and he wanted to get that win back against Ally Aquina because Ally Aquina had beaten him earlier on in his career. But in a fight where Kevin Lee disappointed me, mainly, I don't know if he disappointed you. I don't know if you guys had Ally Aquina winning. This was one for me that made Ally Aquina a real contender at 155. But Kevin Lee didn't perform. Why did he not perform? We don't know. He just couldn't go the five-round distance. And that's going to be a real question I have going into this matchup against Rafael Dos Anjos. So the question is, can Kevin Lee go a strong five rounds? That's a question right now, man. I know he's going to move up. So you have one thing attributing to it, he's moving up in weight, so you're gonna have less fatigue on the mental side, less of a drain of the body on weigh-ins, so hopefully he's a little healthier going into this fight. Maybe that'll help him go five rounds, but from priori experience, it does not look like Kevin Lee has a gas tank to go five rounds. Some people would even say it's worse than Connor's. I wouldn't say that. Connor is a shitty gas tank, but Kevin Lee, one of the guys looked at with a little lesser of a gas tank than you would like, especially for a wrestler like him. You need a gas tank if you're going to put that pressure on your opponent. And we saw in RDA's last two fights that if you can keep a pace for five rounds at a wrestling base, you can defeat this guy by decision. Now, RDA never gets finished, so you're going to have to go five rounds with the guy. You're not going to finish this guy off. RDA came into the welterweight division. He defeated his introduction against Tarek Saffiedine. Then he defeated Neil Magny, the gatekeeper of the division. Then he beat Robbie Lawler. He really announced himself there. He's like, man, I'm here. I want a title shot. Give me Colby Covington. If I beat this guy, I get a title shot. Sadly, he was not able to do that. But if you look at those two losses, those two wrestlers, both were 13-1 when they faced RDA. Colby Covington was 13-1. Usman was 13-1. Usman fought for the title and won the title. He is the world champion. And then Colby Covington is the probably right now at this point the undeniable number one contender in that division. So he still holds the interim title. They stripped him of it, but in my book, he's still the interim champion, so the number one contender. So you can't take that much away from him. Kevin Lee is moving up from 155. He's going to have an adjustment period at 170. RDA is no slouch on the ground. He can stop takedowns. He can get to his feet. He's got good jiu-jitsu. He's not a slouch on the ground. But in his last few fights, everybody's going to go a casual fan or a pretty stable fan of MMA is going to go, if there's a game plan to beat him, can you instill the game plan? Can Kevin Lee instill the game plan for five rounds against RDA? And where's RDA's mental state at? I think I can answer that question. I don't think RDA is one of those guys that has confidence drips if he loses fights back-to-back. He lost his two fights back-to-back. He lost a world title to Eddie Alvarez, then lost to Tony Ferguson, but moved up a weight class and finished three guys in a row. I don't think confidence is really going to be hurting in this fight for RDA. every time RDA ever loses two fights, I think he bounces back for a win. Really, yeah, every single time he's ever lost two consecutive fights, he's won the next one. So that's another statistic to look forward to. Will RDA lose his first three fights in a row? I don't think so. My pick going into the fight is RDA. But if Kevin Lee can answer the question to me, if Kevin Lee can go five rounds with his wrestling base, with his forward pressure, with his strong style wrestling game, and by strong style, I mean he picks you up, he slams, he does the big slams and then ground and pound heavily, then maybe we see Kevin Lee have a successful introduction at 170. And we've been seeing a lot of lightweights moving up to 170 and having some success. Anthony Pettis being the number one case of that. Jorge Masvidal used to be a 155er. He's moved up and he's having some success right around now. So you never know with these 155ers coming up, because there's not that much. The only difference is they're putting on muscle. They're putting on less of a fatigue and less of that issue. They're putting on less stress because they can put on more weight. So you'd expect the guys at 155 to look better in the moves up to 170. And as good as 155 is, you expect them to have success wherever they go. So Kevin Lee has a strong case to win the fight. I've seen a lot of people picking Kevin Lee to win the fight. But where's his gas tank going to take him? Can his gas tank take him five rounds, or is he going to be finished in the fourth or fifth round, or is he going to fall off like he did in the Ally Aquinta fight? And I would have to say he is going to fall off like he did in the Ally Aquinta fight. If the stats are what they say, RDA is not going to lose three fights in a row. I think he bounces back here. He's one of the top guys at welterweight. He was a good move to 155. He's had more time to cope with 155. He's had some brutal wars at 155. So I'm going RDA in the fight. That's my official prediction. I'll be very, very interested to see what happens and what they're going to do moving forward with the decision. But let's just see how this fight goes. I want to know your opinion in the comment section below. Please hit that up and let me know. Let's have a debate if you think Kevin Lee is going to win. If you think that the wrestling of Kamaru Usman and Colby Covington has shown you something that RDA just can't handle wrestlers. You let me know that and anything your heart desires in the comment section below. Make sure you like the video and subscribe to the channel, the best fight game family on YouTube. So make sure you join the fuck up. Let's get it, boys. Cheers, peace, let's get it.